Teens are often characterized as angsty, impulsive, socially inept citizens without fully formed brains, straddling the world of being a child and an adult. But how much of that is true? More after this break. Got a theme song? Roll it. That was the theme song. Someone's getting fired. Adolescence, the end of the beginning of our lives, or the beginning of the beginning of the end of our lives. Sorry, I was raised on My Chemical Romance. I got a lot of like dark thoughts in my head. Back in 3, 2. Adolescent development is categorized by the onset of puberty and ends when we choose our adult identity and behavior. The ages that this occurs has changed over time. People used to think it was 10 to 19 years old, but new research suggests the upper limit is actually 24. Why the change? Well, our bodies are still changing into our 20s and our brains don't fully develop also into our mid-20s. But what does it even mean to be an adult? Being emotionally sound? Making good decisions? A 9:30 bedtime? Well, here are the Teens or Dummies' greatest hits. Teens can't make decisions. Teens are impulsive and they don't know real hip-hop. None of those songs slap, but let's break them down. They Can't Make Decisions is the one we all hear. Got a lot of radio play earlier this year. After the rise of student activism, after school shootings, people derided the kids saying that they couldn't make decisions that young. But while the prefrontal cortex, the part of the brain responsible for abstract thoughts, decision-making, and social behaviors, isn't fully developed by high school age, it doesn't mean that kids aren't ready to make decisions about whether they want to live or not. That's survival instinct. We all have that. And in this case, it's tied directly to traumatic emotions and memories, which encompasses the limbic system, the hippocampus, and ding-dong, the prefrontal cortex. Yeah, there are some decisions kids can't make, like whether or not to buy a certified pre-owned hatchback. I mean, you can't do it by yourself. You gotta get a guarantor on that. But survival is something that people of all ages can make decisions on, especially if it's to stop future trauma based on past ones. 16-year-olds can see school shooters in their school and be like, yeah, I don't want that to happen again. Their brains are formed enough to make choices about wanting doctors or breathable air or polar bears. Man, I miss polar bears. Older people's main reservations about 16-year-olds voting surround their decision-making, whether they're emotionally impulsive and that they don't know how this country really works, but as we see, research suggests otherwise. At age 16, adolescent brains are still developing, whereas older brains begin cognitive decline as early as age 45, so should there be an age cap on voting? Older people vote on issues that affect youth currently who have much less power over the future that they will have to live in. Just a thought. And I get it. The sentence 47th President of the United States, Daniel Bergoglio, terrifies me. But evidence shows that teens are getting smarter, more active, and energized. And the science says that not only are we ready to make those decisions, 16 could be a better age to start forming civic engagement and socially responsible habits as well. Teens are impulsive is kind of reductive. Yes, research suggests that younger people take higher risks, are more impulsive, and their limbic systems aren't fully developed, but this is because their social learning is still being calibrated. Adolescents tend to be bad at reading the emotions of others, but it takes time to learn how to read all the complex social cues, and given the news these days, it sounds like a lot of adults run into those issues as well. Studies show that by age 15, cold cognition, or decision-making based on facts rather than emotions, is almost fully developed, so it's possible that adolescents voting at 18 is A-okay, possibly younger. Millennials are eclipsing baby boomers as a significant block in America's electorate. Generation Z is beginning to get the right to vote, and if current social movements are any indication, change is on the way. With access to information, research suggesting they can be sound decision makers, and the drive to make significant impactful change, I, for one, the first person in history to ever have said this, no one else has said this, say that the kids are all right. Trademark. Here at Seeker, we share stories about science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, so make sure you come back and watch more videos, see? Thanks for watching.